up? Naso, what's up, everybody? How's everybody?
Good, everybody good. Welcome. We're live here at Naso Studios. That's a Mixology Night. Today, we are Disco Ducks. Theme is all about the 70s, cocktails, and all disco music. Excited for this, Mario?
Yes.
It's been a while since our last Mixology. There we go. How's it going?
Hey, it's going great. Hey, it's going great. Excited for another night, another drink. What you got for
us,
Ben?
Well, today we have a cool night. It's been a while since we've done it. Today we're going to do three cocktails, three DJ sets, all 70s mixes. And we're just going to bounce around a little bit, talk about, a little bit about the 70s. If you think about it, the 70s is what, 50 years ago now?
Yeah.
It just sounds crazy. So 50 years is a long time, especially if you're my younger peeps and younger bartending peeps. You want to pick up some cool cocktails. These are some of the cocktails that were very popular back in the 70s. Time where everybody was out partying in the club. If you think the club was popping now, back then it's the original club, where disco is really a combination, starting in the early 70s, a combination of Latin with electric, a little bit of funk, a little bit of soul. And it's just like upbeat, danceable music. And people were partying back then. They were doing cocaine, they were drinking a bunch. But so the first drink out of the three, we're gonna make a Kamikaze. I think it's a cocktail that, even through all the decades, it still stands the test of time because it's just like a party shot, party drink. You had Kamikazes, right?
Yeah, and they're dangerous.
They're fully dangerous because Kamikazes are like the party started shot.
Yes,
this is like the shot. It's mostly alcohol. It's strong acidity with the lime. It just hits you nice and quick. And then the next two cocktails, we're going to make a Long Island iced tea, another classic from the 70s, started in the 70s. And then the third cocktail is called the Grasshopper. But we'll get to those in a little bit. This is really cool stuff. All right, so let's get started with a cocktail. You ready for a drink, right?
Yeah.
Let's go.
So it's funny how you say we're going to start with a Kamikaze. And we're going to do Grasshopper.
Yeah.
Do you know the artist Kamikaze that does the Grasshopper song? Nah.
He's at a disco.
No, I know, but it's funny how he had a song and his name.
What's it called?
The Grasshopper. It starts with a Yes.
Yeah, Hot Stepper.
Yeah. No, but it's part of the song. It's It's the name. Yeah.
Cool. Well, you know what? As always, at the end of our show, we're going to freestyle. We're going to keep making drinks, and Mario's going to go and do his awesome DJ set. And then you can hit us with that in a little bit. All right, so Kamikaze. Let me give you a little close up here. So let's put a little bit of ice in our shaker. It's nice and cold. This kind of shot, you really need to have this nice and cool. Okay, you need a shaker, you're gonna fill that up with ice, and then we're gonna get some fresh squeezed lime juice. Squeeze that. And we're gonna do an ounce of triple sec. Triple sec is a orange liqueur. And a half ounce of the vodka. You know, vodka, one of the most popular spirits in the 70s. Became so popular that, you know, it kind of stuck around and there's a plethora of different cocktails made with vodka. And when I was choosing this, it was hard because there were so many vodka cocktails. And I feel like this is a good one. How did the guy started? I almost made another one. It's called the Harvey Wallbanger. I feel like I was gonna lose everybody. So that one. Kamikaze was one that I always loved 20 years ago when I was starting to party. Love that one. Easy, quick shot. So 2.5 ounces of vodka. Any kind of vodka you like. This is a gluten free vodka that I'm trying to produce. This is called 1941 vodka. If anybody had that, And if anybody's live, we are taping this live. This is live tape. Please chime in on the chat, put any questions, any comments, and even if you're not on the live on the, when we tape this up and leave it recorded for later, please leave in the comments on the descriptions and in the comments below, and I'll reply. Full recipe sauce in the description, so you can at any given time jump on and get a coffee with me. Right. Vodka, triple sec, lime juice, easy peasy. And there, this is my tip.
Take care. Well, we gotta hear it.
You know how long you take a coffee for?
No.
So the cup is cold. Touch the cup.
Oh, okay.
That's cold, right? And you want to see that frosty. See that frosty? Yeah, you want to see.
I didn't know that.
Yeah.
See, I just keep shaking, and I'm thinking one or two, three shake, and that's it.
No. You want. Some cocktails you require very little shaking. If you want it really cold, that'll give you a good shake. Pick that up, then we're gonna shot glasses. This ice and crispy, after dancing out for like 30 minutes and you're sweating, ice Kamikaze.
Do you actually scream like when you drink it? Do you say something like Kamikaze? Something like that?
No. It's funny. This is Kamikaze. If anybody at home is watching, it's inspired from the Japanese 50s, you know, Kamikaze plays where they just like nosedive and get their life and blow themselves up. And that was inspiration from this cocktail.
That's dark, man.
Yeah. I mean, I didn't make it up. This is the cocktail. But yeah, it was dark times back then. So this is our Kamikaze. Come and get your Kamikaze. And here you go, Mario.
Oh, thank you, sir. Thank you. Appreciate it.
With a shot.
Oh, so. Oh. Ooh. Yep.
Kamikaze action. Here we go. Mario and the other ones in two.
So, you know, I take this shot. I'm going to feel very good. I'm going to do my little spin. And
I like the progression. We have our first, second drink. It starts getting losing.
And yeah.
Making the mix with you. This is live, so what happens, happens.
Right.
It doesn't stay here. It's a big world. But here you go. Cheers, right. Homie. Guys, get the coffee. Ah, Kamikaze! Yeah, I don't know. There's a chant.
Woo! But it's smooth though.
That's good. Very smooth.
Yeah.
Very smooth.
Yeah.
You don't feel it. It's nice because I like it because it's just straight citrus. I like that.
Yeah. Yeah, I like drinks like that you don't feel it as much. Where you know you make that face when you take a shot.
Well, vodka is a very neutral spirit. Vodka, yeah. You kind of go anywhere. Doesn't really taste like much.
Yeah.
So. You get a little bit of sweetness from the triple sec. You get a lot of the acidity from the lime. And then when you shake it, you're actually incorporating cold water.
Yeah.
So it does kind of mellow it out. It's not as strong.
Yeah.
So you get this nice.
Yeah.
Then you get tiny little pieces of ice in there from the shaken ice. It's really nice.
That's awesome, though. That was a cool drink. If you guys didn't get an opportunity, make sure you make it because it's really good. It's it definitely gets your party started.
Party started. That was really good. You want to lead us here?
Yeah, of course. I mean, you know, when you think about the 70s, you have to think about John Travolta. Well, you got to think about, I mean, that's what I think when it comes to 70s, you know, John Travolta. And when I think about John Travolta, I think about the Bee Gees. They're pioneers in the 70s. You know, what they created, the music they created is very generational. Your kids even know some of these songs. I play You Should Be Dancing. And my daughter thinks that it's the Minion. That's the Minion song. She doesn't realize that it's not Groot, the original dancer. It's actually John Travolta, the original dancer.
Bee Gees, I think Saturday Night Fever. If anybody has never seen that movie, go on Netflix or whatever, put that on.
Yeah.
It popularized, I mean, disco was already popping because I think the movie came out in the later 70s. But it put disco on the full map.
Oh, yeah. It definitely put...
And the Bee Gees.
And the in the Bee Gees. But I think I think if you want to kind of see what the 70s was about, Saturday Night Live will tell you that story of the 70s. Yeah.
Like
Saturday Night Fever. I'm sorry. Yeah. Yeah. Saturday Night Live is the show. Sorry. Yes. So, yeah, I mean, Saturday Night Fever was definitely a movie where it definitely is generational. I'm telling you. And the dancing. I mean, think about a lot of the dancing that he did in that movie. Today is part of, you know, a lot of kids do that moves without knowing that's part of the 70s. And it's...
Yeah, the origin of a lot of dance music, it's really this
song. Yeah.
The clubs.
The hips. The party. The hand movements. You know, a lot of things, you know.
He's going to the club and like dance.
Yeah.
And having the DJ.
Right.
Start mixing it up.
The records. I mean, I think.
Started off with this song.
Yes. So I want to start off with some of the Saturday Night Fever music or soundtrack. And what good way to start if this is Friday, we're leading into Saturday. So nothing like Night Fever. I hope I got you in the mood. I got you with the Saturday Night Fever soundtrack. And trust me, it was a soundtrack. It was that CD. Well, back in the days, right, we had CDs. And they had what you call records and tapes. Well, I'm just telling you, that was probably one of the most selling soundtracks for a while. Until Celine Dion came and hit it with Titanic. But Saturday Night Fever was a soundtrack that most people actually purchased because of all these hits. And again, like I said, that movie is generational. I mean, think about it. Disco Inferno, you had Casey and the Sunshine Band, you had the Bee Gees, you just had many records on that. And it was definitely one soundtrack will have your whole party going off, just have it on replay. So I hope you enjoyed it, but now we're gonna go to Mr. Sassone himself.
You know, we're in the 70s, and I prepared us a little treat. 70s hors d'oeuvre, popular dish from back in the 70s. That's popular nowadays, but It really blew up in the 70s.
What you got there? What you got there?
What's up? What's up with that?
Let me see.
Woo! Nothing fancy. Pigs in the blanket.
Okay.
Pigs in the blanket. Have one.
Oh, of course. I'm in the mood.
Puff pastry.
I'm in the mood right now.
You're in the mood. You keep saying you're in the mood. Where is the mood?
How deep is your love? Wifey, you know, how deep is your love?
Here.
Cheers.
70's reserve. I'll put these here. Maybe we'll take them down in a second. Great mix. Great mix. We're live on TikTok as well. For everybody at home, welcome back to Mixology Night. You get Mario, check the soul in the house. You get also in the ones and twos.
Look.
Nice mix. Now we're going to make our next cocktail. A little hot dog. We're going to make a Long Island iced tea.
Ooh, my favorite.
Yeah, that's my favorite drink too.
You know
man.
What?
That's my favorite drink.
It's listen. Drink. Growing up, obviously, you know, you're 21. You're not. You don't have that much money to be spending on drinks. Mm-hmm. All you need, yeah. It was Long Island, and that's it. It had you right for the whole night.
It was like $5 Long Island.
Yes. Yes.
$5 Long Island.
For those who were in, well, if you live in Florida, we're from Florida, and actually South Florida.
Miami,
so there is this spot called Gabby's on Pembroke Pines,
yep.
And it was on the corner of Pines and Hiatus, and it was $5. No, Gabby Lounge
in the outskirts. Of
yeah, it was before you got to Iguana, yeah. But that club or that lounge lasted for years. But it was famous for their $5 Blue Long Island. It was Blue Long Island. Yes. But you took that drink and that's it. That's all you needed.
It's the same recipe, but with a shot of
Curaçao. Yeah. And what's funny was that it was a $5 entrance, but they'll give you the $5 back as a ticket so you get your Blue Long Island.
Yeah, yeah.
Nice.
I mean, you drink two of those. You're ready to party then.
Yeah.
That was like my threshold with Long Island.
Yeah.
I don't trust myself with a Long
Island. Oh, now today?
After two, it's like, okay.
After two kids?
One, I'm good. Two, I'm get the full Monty,
yeah.
Full Montes. Anything beyond that, it's I don't remember.
You know what's crazy though? That you there's always drinks that are your go-to until that one night, and then you become afraid of them.
And well, that one's definitely not my go-to. But it's an amazing, great drink. And this drink originated in Long Island, New York.
I feel right now like, you know, Jessica Simpson when she had like the tuna moment. Is this chicken or
yeah.
I thought Long Island iced tea was Caribbean.
Really Caribbean?
Because of the island tea.
Yeah. You know what? I didn't really know what Long Island was, being from South Florida.
Right. I thought island iced tea. Oh, that's Caribbean drink. I didn't know it was from New York.
Yeah. Early on, I didn't know Long Island. So fun fact: Long Island is in New York. Is it even a bro? Is it a thing? But they love to drink. So this cocktail has a little bit of everything, a little bit of all the liquors that are in the well drinks. You don't have to make it with bad stuff, but we're gonna get started. You ready for Long Island?
Yes, of course.
Let's do this. So get your shaker. Let's get some ice in the mix. And you know what? There's no iced tea in the cocktail. There's no ice tea. It's called Long Island because the taste and it resembles the color and a little bit of the flavors of an iced tea, like a southern iced tea, but it has nothing, right?
Another moment, I thought they had a bucket of tea in Arizona. I thought they had the Arizona in there.
They had iced tea on it, yeah.
Oh, Lord.
You guys have no clue what's in this.
Yeah, cup. The whole time I was drinking, I thought it was liquor and tea.
But that's fine. And if you're watching, I'm sure you have no clue either. If you're watching over there, I'm sure you have no clue. All right, so we're going to begin with all the clear spirits. We're going to go with triple sec, an ounce of triple sec. It's going to give it a little sweetness, a little bit of an orange flavor. Pop that in there. Next clear, vodka.
Yeah, nice.
Vodka is always a sucker punch at it. You just put it in the mix, you can't do it. Yep, I'm a little louder. Hey, guys. So we have a shot of triple sec, an ounce of triple sec, an ounce of vodka, now an ounce of
Bacardi.
Or light rum. White rum. I like Bacardi for my coffees. Then we're gonna do 1 ounce of gin.
Okay.
I'm looking forward to that one. I go to Japan.
And then you do tequila too?
A shot of tequila, an ounce of tequila.
Oh wow. I didn't know I was drinking all that. No wonder. No wonder that was your one drink that you need the whole night. You have like a combination of all five.
Come on, you have five different spirits in one cocktail. Right now this is like a jungle juice.
Yeah.
You wouldn't think you could, it wouldn't even taste good.
Right.
But you'd be surprised. We're gonna do 1 ounce of lime juice. An ounce of lemon juice. Old school recipes, they use sour mix, but I'm a chef. I can't do sour mix.
Yeah, right.
I like fresh citrus.
You gotta be fresh.
Cocktails. Yeah, and if you're making craft cocktails and roots to the home, use fresh citrus. And so we're gonna shake this up. Let me tap. Boom.
So, question. So, I'm guessing that a lot of time when you drink Long Island and it's brown, it's because of the rum, because they might use dark rum.
Show you.
Oh, cool.
I'm gonna show you now. Secret ingredient comes.
Oh, gotcha.
So first you're gonna shake our citrus with all the spirits in there. Then we're gonna shake that up really good. And then we're gonna serve that in a Collins glass, which is a little bit taller than the highball. You can also use the Hurricane glass, kind of those goblets.
Yeah.
We have a red can. We have a red can. That's the secret ingredient.
Oh.
When you put it in a pouch of Coca-Cola.
I thought it was
Coca-Cola. Coca-Cola is not our sponsor, but I like Coca-Cola. You can use any kind of cola.
The whole time I thought it was ice. What made it dark was the iced tea.
No, there's no iced tea.
It resembles
an iced tea, but there is no iced tea.
So I have a question, right?
Yeah.
What determines a drink to be served in a tall glass and in a small glass? Like for instance, this one, I noticed they always serve it in those type of glass.
There is no real strict law. Each cocktail has its own glassware.
Okay.
So that's why there's so many different glasses. Some because it helps with the carbonation. But I wouldn't tell you exactly why. Sometimes the guy who created a drink just said, you know what, let's put in this drink, and kind of stuck.
Right.
Because that's kind of like what they came up with.
Gotcha.
So these are like the highballs, not as short, a little taller. And so it looks kind of clear, but what makes it brown, you're going to put a splash of Coca-Cola on this.
Okay.
About an ounce. Give it that little
there is your iced tea.
There's your little iced tea action. Give it a little mix up. It's
wow,
it's
like
ice
wow, tea.
Nice.
Look at that.
Nice
little lemon wedge.
You know, for the first time, I'm more excited to drinking this one than ever because I feel like
this is a proper.
Yeah, this is like original. This is like an OG.
This is not a frat house cocktail.
Yeah, I feel like I've been bamboozled the whole time.
Wow.
Woo! This does look nice though.
Mario, you okay?
Try that.
Well, no.
Take that.
This is good. This is good, people. If you made it at home, it's good.
It's supposed to taste like a regular iced tea.
Yeah, no. This is actually, you don't feel at all. And I mean, normally when you actually, some people, there's places that know how to do Long Island iced tea, and there's places that you're just like,
I don't remember any place.
Yeah, this actually fresh. If you're right now outside and it's hot.
Yeah, this is exactly for that.
Yeah.
Summer party.
Right.
Outside party.
Like you're drinking an actual iced tea, but you don't realize that this iced tea is going to be your last one.
And in the 70s, I'm telling you, the 70s, they party hard. They it partied hard. Disco is the beginning of party music, party vibe. So when you're partying, you're drinking, and the cocktail.
No, and the combination at that time, but we know what happened in the 70s, right? The introduction of the powder and the drugs and everything.
Yeah, cocaine was huge back then. And this is a, we're talking about partying. Partying, people are partying.
Yeah.
And it's a strong cocktail.
And I'm assuming, I don't know, but back in the days, you know, I believe that when you made your drink, they were to the point where it needed to be, you know, because a lot of people probably couldn't afford to go to disco. Like, I don't know. I'm assuming that it was probably expensive.
I don't know. If we're talking about Studio 54, which is that's the elite,
yeah, right,
elite of the clubs, you couldn't even get in, even get money.
Yeah. Exactly. Yeah. And well dressed, too. There was a.
Yeah, be young, well dressed. Yeah. Be like a movie star or just certain level. This is fantastic, right?
Yeah, it's amazing. I mean, let me just quickly. I want to look at something like. I just want to know, what was the cause of Long Island iced tea?
Back in the.
Yeah.
Like 20 years ago?
Yeah.
I remember getting it for $5 a pop.
No, but I want to know, like.
Before we go.
In the 70s.
My drink, let's go.
Let's get the close up on this one.
Put up a little iced tea, though.
A little bit of iced tea?
Yeah, I'm driving.
Yeah, we'll give you more coke for you. Coca Cola. A little bit of ice. This one I'm not gonna measure.
Don't measure.
All right,
that's the best drink.
A splash.
Don't measure. Splash.
So, once you know what an ounce is, you can get a splash. Or what do you call a glug? Glug?
Glug?
It's a glug. An ounce. A glug is an ounce.
That's a glug.
Fresh lemon juice and fresh lime juice. E ingredient. E ingredient. That's gonna be so
nice. Nice.
Right. Man. Like this we go.
Yeah, I'm getting ready for this, man. And next set, while George is over here shaking and that, when we thinking about the 70s, we're just thinking about, we can't just think about the fellas. We got to think about the divas. There were divas singing their hearts out. You know, we had Donna Summer, Diana Ross, I meant to say. We had Diana Ross, Donna Summer. We had other, you know, we had groups. That they were basically performing in the 70s.
ABBA.
But they were strictly for the females, though. I mean, a lot of 70 music was strictly. A lot of 70 music, disco, was really tailored to encourage women, right? Like, I think Donna Summer was one of the pioneers. Woo! Donna Summer was one of the pioneers to kind of give that woman empowerment.
Oh, yeah. I think the 70s, and didn't we do Women in Power?
We did.
Yeah, we did.
We did.
What about Mixology? You want a Mixology? And if you're watching, we have a playlist of all the Mixology nights that we're accumulating, so let's start from the beginning. Let's start watching them all. We did some cool Afrobeats. It's pretty cool. One of my favorite ones.
Right. We have Latin Night. We have Latin Night. We have had 90s. Yeah. And we're going to have to do more, so make sure you just start following us, you know? Yes.
You got any ideas for the next
one? Of course.
I'm thinking like an 80s prom one. I want to do a
freestyle.
Yes.
Yes, of course.
Now we're done. We definitely got to do something electric dance.
Yes.
We'll do that. Maybe we'll do an ultra.
Oh. Ultra one? It just passed, but.
Yeah, it just passed. Yeah,
it got ruined by rain.
But all right, guys. Well, let's jump in. Let's jump into the next mix. Here we go. Did you try the pick in the blank?
So, as I was saying, George, with the 70s and the divas, one of the things that I do like about the 70s is I feel that era, especially Donna Summer, she made it good for females to feel sexy and to be sexy. And even though most of her songs people did not appreciate it at the beginning, it was hard to resist. So,
Donna Summer's.
Yeah. Yeah. So, just to go ahead and start, there's nothing to start with. Love to love you, baby.
You're the one who tried to hurt me with goodbye. You think I crumble? You think I Mario!
Yo, DJ, you know how, baby. I told you I was gonna get you ready for tonight, and I was in the mood.
Get ready, get ready.
I'm telling you, the mood is getting to another level. So I
stay
Let's go. All right, so check it out. I'm like Sasson's background dancer right now.
There you go.
Let's go.
Grasshopper cocktail that originated in Orleans. But in the 70s, you know, cream-based cocktails was like the thing. Cream-based cocktail was like
yeah,
thing by thing. Brandy Alexanders, White Russians. So in picking this, the next cocktail, I wanted to pick a cream-based cocktail. And the Grasshopper is one that just stood out because you don't really see it as often. It's just a classic that's not really done that often. But I think it should make a comeback. I think the Grasshopper, you know what, mark my words. From here to the next year, the Grasshopper might make a comeback.
Yeah.
You heard it here first. So the Grasshopper, look at that. Beautiful, nice green cocktail.
Is that going to be the next Long Island Iced Tea replacement?
No. This is his own thing. This is more of a dessert drink. So the Grasshopper is heavy cream, creme de menthe, which is this. Creme de menthe. It's a spirit made with mint. Flavor with mint, and we're gonna use creme de cacao, which is another spirit flavored with chocolate. So we have chocolate and mint. This is gonna taste like a mint chocolate ice cream. That's exactly what it's gonna taste like. It's more of an after dinner drink. It's more of a, I don't like calling drinks girly drinks because that's over with. I think everybody likes everything, and there's no reason to put down a drink and call it a girly. But it's definitely a more dessert drink. It's not one that you're gonna pound three or four, because it has cream and it might mess you up a little. All right, so we're gonna make the cocktail. We're gonna make two recipes. The recipe makes for two cocktails here. We're gonna do 3 ounces of heavy cream. You can substitute with half and half if heavy cream is a little strong for you. Heavy cream, fill it up with ice. I don't picture myself dancing disco with heavy cream.
Well, you don't know.
Me personally. No, I do know.
I see myself.
Yeah. I see you.
I don't need any type of drink.
So, a little, 2 ounces of cacao, creme de cacao. This is the creme de menthe, and that's gonna give that beautiful green. So St. Patrick's Day, I think this is a great time to make this cocktail. Make this dessert. Look at this stuff right here. It's just like aesthetically looks cool. So it could be a Halloween cocktail. You know, just the color alone is just like get some people asking what takes that. That's what popping.
That tells you that drink is going to be having us popping. Right?
Yeah, you want to really pop it.
Popping them colors.
And when you shake, you know, the cream is often going to get a little frosty, kind of creamy in there. Good.
Does the cream be played, for example, some cocktails, they use egg white to create a frosty pop? Is that the cream? Is that what it's doing?
So I don't think it replaces it because the cream on itself is just going to give it a silky kind of ice cream kind of texture in your palate, on your mouth. It does not replace it, but it does. When you mix it up, the cream, you know, you make whipped cream with heavy cream. So the more you whip it up, the cream is going to puff up with volume and it is going to get a little frothy. similar to like an egg drink. So we'll definitely get that volume. And we're gonna strain that. Very simple, three ingredients.
Look at that, guys. Get ready. Oh my god.
Up.
Are you guys watching this? Right here, TikTok, are we live? Hello? There you go, look at that. That looks good.
And then the classic garnish, a little bit of chocolate shavings. I like to use some bittersweet chocolate. And then just shave on one side of the cocktail. Very elegant.
Very elegant, just on the side though.
I'm about to drink this with the pinky out.
Yeah, this is...
Your pinky!
Go to a restaurant and ask for this.
And ask for the grasshopper. Thank you. Sensei. if you smell it. Mm.
Yeah, smell that?
Smell that?
Yeah.
You get the chocolate?
Yeah, you think this is like someone went ahead and... Be careful. Make sure is there liquor in there? They could just go ahead and...
This is like Kermit the Frog pureed in the blender.
Yeah.
Cheers, Owen.
Cheers. It smells like ice cream.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Like a mint chocolate chip.
Yeah.
Like a peppermint patty.
Oh, yeah.
It's a New York peppermint patty.
And you don't even taste... You're... Yeah. Oh, yeah.
That is dangerous.
Oh, yeah. No, you don't. You know, this is a drink. This is a drink that I think, fellas, if you want to impress your lady.
Easy.
Are you saying that's a
girly
drink?
No.
We can't celebrate our problem.
Yeah. Well, no, I'm just saying because, you know, a lot of females like drinks. And I think this is a good, perfect.
This for dessert?
Yeah. It is. He mentioned.
Love that drink.
Yeah.
She loves anything that's green, mint, and chocolate.
My wife will love this drink just to the point where she doesn't even know that she's about to get destroyed. Because, like, this one, you know, margaritas, and that's like a woman drink, the sex on the big beach and everything, and they could taste it. But this one right here, you're basically, it's very creamy.
Yeah, it's cheek, and it tastes like ice cream. This one's
really good. That's the word. It tastes like ice cream.
I think I recommend this drink to anybody that loves mint chocolate chip ice cream.
Hey, I'll be honest. I'm not a fan of mint chocolate chip, but I'm going to try the drink. And I'm pretty sure from this point on, I'm going to buy it.
But it's different. Like, Miguel, the thing is, it's different from the chocolate. Like,
see, we have it. It's my favorite thing.
Yeah,
I love the mint.
Yeah.
Love the mint. The green color, it's weird.
Yeah.
And then the chocolate, it's a plus. The shaving, dark chocolate.
You know, this is a drink that you have to also sip it. You can't just chug it. You gotta...
I feel like I'm drinking this fast.
No, I drank it fast because I'm already, you know, at Long Island. But I'm just saying, like, this drink right here, you gotta enjoy it. It's not a drink where you're gonna...
It feels like I just got it from Starbucks.
Yeah.
Bingo.
Starbucks.
Yeah.
Hey, let me get a grasshopper.
I'll take a grande grasshopper. Yeah.
A venti. Yeah, let me. Venti. Yes. You know what? It does. It does taste like that. Like that tea. They have
matcha.
Yes.
My wife. She loves.
Yes. Matcha, if so think about
like,
it. That.
Every time I look at him, like that's matcha. Like,
yes.
And I don't drink milk either.
So it's the same taste, guys. This is for the ladies. Fellas, too. You could drink it too.
No, you just said it, man. It's for the ladies.
Well, hey.
What I say, if it's for the ladies,
it's for us too, because if the ladies like it, we're winning. You know, it's a W. Fellas, it's Friday night.
Don't matter.
Listen, go get the ingredients. If your wife is not giving you a good sign, go ahead, make it this special drink.
There you go.
And then guess what?
Great. Don't take our murder advice. But make this cocktail at home and get the groove on.
But what? Hey, what if it works? We're going to get more likes, though. So, fellas, I'm telling you.
Hey, you know what to do, man. Hit that like button.
And subscribe.
Fellas, you don't have to get a Louis Vuitton bag. Just get him a drink of this and that's... and you get them in the bag.
So, disco and hip-hop.
Oh, yeah.
How many beats that we love, how many songs that we love, is derived from disco? You know, disco has what really originated hip-hop. The break.
Yeah.
Right? The breaks. What is the break? The middle of the part song where it's just like a jam of the song.
I mean,
hip-hop originated from cutouts of breaks looped together to make a whole song, which now is called a sample.
Yeah.
Right? So most of the badass hip-hop songs that we know are born out of a disco song.
Yeah. That's true. I mean, that's true.
I know you made a compilation of some...
I did. I mean, you have a lot of producers that, you know, took beats from the 70s and created also generational hits, but sampled from the 70s. I mean, Diddy was not only just doing his thing, but he was sampling too. You know, Diddy, hey. I guess that's where he started. He sampled that, and that's where he gets his behavior from. But I'm just saying, you know.
He won't stop.
And we won't stop. Uh-huh, uh-huh. But yeah.
But no.
In all seriousness, a lot of the music that we hear today, it's crazy how a lot of these kids, you talk to your kids in a car and they listen to a song and they're like, oh, this is the, and you put the original, it's like, who's that? And I'm like, this is the original song, this is the original person who actually made this hit. And they're just thinking that we're just taking that, it, no, they discover it, they're the genius. No,
I think there's such a beautiful thing in that, because right, like you say, right, Jaden, your son, he's like, what the heck is that?
Yeah.
Then you play on the original.
Yes.
And you're kind of like passing on the torch.
Previous
generations where people say like, oh, I'm so tired of people mashing up this and that. We're actually carrying a little piece of each generation, moving along, tweaking it along. And that's actually the evolution of music and as a whole, just like
and
evolution.
And not only that, you make a connection with your kids, you can make a connection with the young crowd too, because at the same time, it's like you kind of tell them a story. Oh my gosh, I remember this beat, and this beat came out, and I remember I was a teenager and we were all crazy because this song came out
back in my days, right? we have a little skit at home.
You know what's a good movie right now? Kids are looking at like, oh my god, that song is so good. Have you guys watched Trolls, the new Trolls movie?
Oh, Trolls! No.
Hey, it's really good because he has a lot of old songs.
And Trolls do that. And also, the other movie that is also Happy Feet. Okay. They take a lot of songs that are back in the 70s.
So it's in the 2000s.
Yeah.
But it does take a lot of old
music. And when you play these songs for the kids.
And not because it's old, because the 70s is 50 years old.
And you know, a lot of things that is refreshing this music.
It's not even our generation.
And I think this is why, one of the reasons why we decided to do 70s is because TikTok, Instagram, a lot of kids.
Oh, yeah.
A lot of
reels.
Yes.
Just to let you know, we do have a special request.
Yes.
Smooth operator.
Okay. Oh, okay.
Smooth operator, right?
Oh.
It's a 90s. That's a 90s song.
Yeah. But we got you. We got you.
But we still got you.
We got you. Hey, we got you. No matter what.
Hey, DJ Mario, special.
Special request?
We have the request coming in because they know.
Got you.
We're at the back.
Who gave us the special request?
We're about to start.
That is going to be
our after party.
Okay.
Mickey.
Mickey, I see you.
Mickey D. What up, Nikki?
But
Mickey.
Before I get into this set, you know, a lot of TikTok and Instagram.
Yeah, the reels.
Yes, they go ahead and do all these dances to the music that we grew up to. And 70 music, and it's crazy because it's kind of like it never dies.
I think it's cool. It's just I love the mashups.
It never dies. I think when good music exists, it will never die.
Well, good music is evergreen.
Yeah.
Good music will only stand the test of time.
Yes.
Doesn't matter the generation.
Right.
So that is amazing stuff. And that's what we like to cover here in Mixology. But you know what? I think it's been an amazing show. We had three cocktails.
And a bit of a shout out to people on TikTok.
On TikTok, if you're watching, hey, watch the show from the beginning. We're going to jump into our after party in a couple minutes. The After Party, it's on YouTube.
Yes.
It's a song channel. DJ Rio is going to go freestyle and take any request. If you're in the chat right now watching on YouTube, put your request. We're going to jump and have a little After Party. We're gonna have another Long Island.
Yes, I'm gonna do that.
We're going to have another Long Island. We're gonna do some requests, and we're going to continue on.
Yes.
And for those that missed the show, this is going to go take live. So in an hour or so, jump back on it. The recipes are in the comments. Please leave a comment if you watch. If you haven't, leave a comment. I always jump on there. And that you guys are subscribers. Thank you guys always for subscribing and liking and all that good stuff.
Hey, Jeff, we got one more last question for you.
Even though.
You know, they're asking, the ladies are asking, man, you know, why are you so, a little bit of, like, you know, are you red, your face is all red, and like,
oh my God, right?
Like, you're blushing, what's going on, man, you getting hot, or is the drinks,
is it me? is it me? You're right, I do, I'm looking at myself, I just got rosy, I don't know.
You got rosy, man.
I think they're making me blush.
I don't know. It might be the drink.
Yeah, you drink them and I get red.
There we go.
That's what happens when
the more you drink, the more red he gets.
I get endearing and warm.
You know, that is true. Actually, that is true. The more you drink,
the more endearing.
Yeah.
I'm a little jar of peanut butter. I'm a little jar of jam.
You know, next time we're gonna make a fun fact about George.
Just follow
his Instagram page, and we're gonna go out drinking, and we're gonna try the test of how red can he get.
Yo, to TikTok, we're gonna have a special event backstage with Jeff's song, asking very, very needy, very naughty questions.
Needy, naughty questions.
Needy and naughty. He's gonna be.
I don't know how
naughty he's gonna get. He's gonna get
so red. Fun fact: we used to call these sessions back in the day. Remember? Yeah. Sessions.
These sessions.
Straight from
Steps of Zone. I love it. There we go.
And I'm so, for one, yeah. Goodbye. Everybody, live from Sassone Studios. I am Chef Sassone, your master host and mixologist. DJ Rio is about to take over.
Let's go.
Miguel, you're gonna sign us off later.
So I'm gonna go ahead and let's go back into the 70s, and I'm gonna do some mashup with hip hop. So just to kind of show you how the 70s still influences today. Let's go.
Hey guys, don't go anywhere. Stay tuned and stay in the stream. We're still going to party all night long. Maybe not all night long, but we're gonna be here for quite a while. Hey, listen, jam, drink. Have a good night, guys.
My dogs do. high. Take it to the high.